हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द सेकंड चैप्टर ऑफ मैथ्स, दैट इज पॉलिनोमियल्स। द फर्स्ट एक्सरसाइज इज टू शॉर्ट बेसिकली, एंड वी आर फैमिलियर विद क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशंस। We have gone through quadratic equations. We have solved these quadratic equations, which basically has quadratic equation is the equation which has highest power 2. It is basically a polynomial. It has the highest power 2. We will come to know more in detail in exercise 2.2. Before going further, I like to tell you the general form of quadratic equation is ax square plus bx plus c. This is the general form of quadratic equation, and the quadratic equation is in the form of x. So usually we write p of x. Means this polynomial is in the form of x, where a is the coefficient of x square, b is the coefficient of x, and c is the constant. If supposing tomorrow we have got a m square plus bm plus c, then it will be written as polynomial in the form of m. If it is a quadratic polynomial, so it will have highest power 2, that you know very nicely. Binomial, so it will be having, binomial is having only two terms. So cubic is again there. For cubic, you will have a x cube plus b x square plus cx plus d, and this will be again in the form of x. This is a cubic polynomial because it has got highest power 3. So we have to solve these polynomials. Especially this is the most important polynomial that we'll be dealing. Some cases we have got this polynomial also to deal with, and we have to know how to solve this polynomial. This we'll be doing in detail in exercise 2.2. Let us first understand that a zero, which again we will be doing it in detail with in polynomial in exercise 2.2. But what is zero? Because we are dealing over here graphs of y is equal to px. So here you can see this is a graph. You can see in your textbook. My Xerox may not be very neat to appear. This is a graph. Graph is basically any fashion in which your equation is behaving. This is how, if you will trace different values of x, if you will take, supposing any graph is there, an equation is given. In that equation, if you go on substituting different values of x, so you will keep on getting different values of p of x. So for that value of x, what is your equation? That will go on, in that way you will go on tracing these graphs. At present, this exercise deals with find the number of zeros. What is a zero? For any equation that is given to you, supposing if I have got x square plus 3x plus 12, something of this sort. Okay, so actually it can be minus 12 over here. This is not a very, very nice equation. Still, if I have to really use an equation, then I'll have to really trace it. Minus 12 hoga to. Plus 1x can be one equation. Here what happens if we solve this equation, you should now, what is a zero? Zero is that number. When you substitute that value for x, then this will become a zero. The value of this will become zero. Like supposing if I go for minus 4 and 3, just hope it works. If I go for minus 4 and 3, if I substitute minus 4 in the place of x, I'll get this will become plus 16 minus 4 minus 12. minus 16, 0. That means minus 4 is a 0 of this polynomial. Similarly, if I substitute 3, it will become 3 square plus 3 minus 16. 3, 3 is a 9 plus 3 minus 16. No, okay, 9, 10, 11, 12, no, it is not working. So then that means 3 is not a, but this should not have happened. Plus 4 minus 3, plus 4 minus 3. Oh, it is 12 over here, sorry. This is 12. 9, 10, 11, 12, minus 12 is 0. As I told you, this should have not happened. So this is the way that you have to understand, my dear students. See, mistakes happen, but you have to understand that you have to should be able to understand something is going wrong, and for that a logic is needed. At present, that I can't explain the logic how I understood that this something is going wrong, because 3 has to be the 0. Why? That I will not, at present our base has not become that strong for you to understand why I understood that 3 has to be the 0. So forget, right now you only understand 0 means it is a value that we have to substitute in the place of x, so that this equation becomes 0, this polynomial becomes 0. That is the meaning of this, and this is when you are doing it algebraically. When the same thing, when you are presenting it in a geometrical form like this, in the form of a coordinate geometry, in the form of a graph, then 0 is what? 0 is that point, that x coordinate where the graph is cutting the x axis. So if I know what is this point at present, if supposing this would have been, supposing this would have been 1, 2, this would have been 2.5. So for this graph, 2.5 is the 0 of that polynomial. In this case, if you see, minus 1, minus 2, approximately minus 2, not exactly minus 2, it is somewhere around minus 1.8. So minus 1.8 is a 0 of this graph. Also here, 1 is the 0 of this graph, also here. The point where the coordinate where the graph intersects the x-axis, that is the 0 of that polynomial of which the graph is. This will be slightly confusing for you all people, how basically the polynomial is presented in a frame of a graph. At right now, I will not go in that detail, though it is not that difficult, but it is not there in your portion, so we will be unnecessarily investing our time over there. If sometimes you need that, so I'll make a new video for that, separate video for that. But at present, to stick to it, the question is what? The graph y is equal to p of x. This is the graph. For some polynomials p of x, find the number of zeros in each case. Find the number of zeros means, see, the graph has to cut the x-axis. The graph is cutting over here and nowhere else, only one point. So in question number 2, number of zeros is 1. 0 is a post, it is a label, it is a name. This 0 is different and this 0 is different. See, in this case, if supposing it is 2.5, supposing it is 2.5, so 2.5 is the 0 of that polynomial. Right? 2.5 is the 0. Now 2.5 cannot be 0. I can't say 2.5 is equal to 0. They are not, definitely it is not equal to 0. But it is not this 0. 2.5 is 0 of the polynomial. It means it is 2.5. When you substitute it in the place of the variable and you solve, the polynomial will get converted into this 0. So like this, the graph is cutting x-axis only at one point, so this will have only 1, 0. For third question, graph is cutting 1, 2, 3 points, so number of zeros will be 3. Right, the complete statement, number of zeros for question number 3 is 3. If you think about question number 2, it is cutting x-axis where? It is cutting x-axis at 2 points. So number of zeros is 2. Here it is cutting 1, 2, 3, 4 places. So number of zeros will be 4. Here 1, 2, 3. So in sixth question, 1, 2, 3. Number of zeros is 3. Now I have left question number 1 because this graph is not cutting x-axis in any place. Because it is not cutting x-axis anywhere, therefore this graph will not have a zero. It will not have a zero, it will not have a solution, it will not have a root. All mean the same. Zero, roots, solution, all mean the same. This will not have a zero. The zero number of zeros is, therefore there is no zero for y is equal to p of x. Okay, my dear student, this topic is very, very, very short. Just to introduce, because this is too short, one more I like to complete a basic thing. See, one more question can come. It comes, basically it was in 9th standard. Identify if a given polynomial is a quadratic equation. See, if it is a quadratic equation, or even if it is a polynomial or not a polynomial. If it is a quadratic polynomial, it is a different thing. If it is a polynomial, again there is a different question on this. Remember, whether the given expression is a polynomial or not a polynomial, it depends who is going to decide. Only and only the variable is going to decide. Power of the variable, not even variable. Power of the variable is going to decide. Supposing if it is x cube minus 2x square plus 7. See, these powers, these are going to decide. These coefficients 1, 2, 7, they have got no role to play. They can be any numbers, anything. The coefficients can be anything. But you have to see that the powers of the variable, you have to check them. These powers of the variables have to be non-negative integers. Remember, you know integers. Integers 0, 1, 2, 3, up to infinity. And on the left hand side, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. These all are not there. Non-negative integers means all the positive integers and a 0. From 0 up, all these are integers. Only these numbers can be the power of the variable. Any other number, and then that polynomial is, that expression is not a polynomial. And if it is a quadratic equation or not, then the highest power has to be 2. Highest power has to be 2. If the highest power is 2, satisfying these conditions, highest power 2 and all other powers, highest power 2, supposing 3m square minus 5 upon 2m plus 7. Then the highest power is 2, then 1. This is a quadratic polynomial. Even if supposing it is 7 upon root 7 upon 5 x square plus 5, highest power is 2, then there is no other power. Still, this is a quadratic polynomial because highest power is 2. This, if I go to write it in a standard form, I can write it as this way. This is the standard form where each and every power is to be seen. But in this case, what will happen? The coefficient is 0. Okay, in this case, the power is 0. Okay, that's why this is x to the power of 0 is 1. That's why you don't have to write it. It is 1, 5. So this is the basics. Otherwise, see, these coefficients can be anything, but you can't write it as 7 root x plus 5x plus 7. This is not a quadratic equation, it is not a polynomial at all. Because if I go to write this in the power form it will become x raised to the power of half. Remember, root, square root, when I write it in a power form, the radical goes and power becomes half, plus 5x plus 7. Then in this case, the power of the first term is not an integer. It is positive, but it is not an integer. That's why this is not going to be a polynomial. Okay, it has to be a non negative means positive and zero, non negative integer. What the power of the variable, remember the power of the variable has to be non negative integer. There is no condition on the coefficients and the constant. They can be anything. They can be under roots, they can be decimals, they can be any real number, any real number. But the power has conditions in it. Okay, my dear students, with this, some amount of basics are over. Soon we will be returning with exercise 2.2, where the actual chapter starts. Okay, my dear students, see you all soon. Thank you. Love you all.